What's up, guys? We're back at home here. I wanted to quickly go over the setups that I use for catching striped bass. It's mid-March now, going to late March, and striped bass are starting to show up on the beaches around here. So I thought maybe it was a good time to go over what I'm using and how you can set up if you want to go out and catch these yourself. I did one for perch a couple weeks back, so I'll link that one in the description below. A lot of the stuff is similar. Nice thing about fishing around here is, you know, you can use a lot of the same stuff for perch and striped. Check that one out if you want to see more information about surf perch. So let's get right into it. If you watched my other video, the rod and reel is going to look a lot very familiar to you. It's the same exact one. So 10-foot Shimano Convergence paired up with a 4000 Sahara. The only difference being on this one is that I prefer when striped fishing to use braid. As opposed to mono. So for a couple of the rigs I'll go over later on, but especially when you're plugging for striper, you definitely want the braid so that you can cast it farther. And then another benefit is also you can carry more line because you never know when you might hook to a big one. So that's what I got for rod and reel. Let's start going over the setups now. By the way, got my Sand Crab Classic shirt on. I got from the derby I was in last weekend. If you want to check out that video, I'll leave that one in the description below as well. It was a good derby, had a lot of fun, met some cool people. And yeah, it's a good event. Highly recommend it if you guys are thinking about doing it. So I'll leave that video in the description below if you want to check it out. I did a quick video on what went down. Okay, so getting into the setups, there's three different kinds of setups that I'm going to go over. All three of these I actually went over for the perch fishing how-to vid, but I'll go in a little bit more of the specifics on what I use for striped bass. In general, everything is just scaled up a notch because striped bass, obviously, you know, they're bigger, fight more. So I'll go into the details on what I use once I start going here. So really quick, before I start going over the setups, as for the braid, my preference is 30-pound braid. So different people eat it like it goes heavier, lighter, but for me, I prefer to use 30. So, and this one's actually, this braid's getting old, so I'm actually gonna swap this out. So let's do that now. Okay, so first thing when you're spooling up with braid, you always wanna have some backing of either mono or fluoro. And the reason for that is braid is really slick, so if you put a braid straight onto the spool, it'll slip. When you're either, you know, bringing in big fish or when you have any tension on it. So first thing, you want to put down some fluoro. So I have any fluoro will work. I think this is 20-pound. Just put on the bottom here, just enough to cover the bottom of the spool there. So once you got that on, then you take your mono, tie it straight to the braid, and start spooling. Okay, so I got my mono right here tied to the braid. I believe this knot's called a double uni knot. So you can look that up on YouTube if you want to see how to tie that one. But any kind of knot will work. It's not really that important. For the most part, you're not going to be seeing this knot. It's going to be down on the spool. So once you got that knot there, then you can go ahead and start spooling up your line. Okay, so when you're spooling your line, you want to button down the drag as much as possible, and then I like to use an old rag to keep tension on the line. So when you're spooling up, you don't want it to go loose at all. So you want it to be tight on the spool here. So if you get it loose, that's when you get in trouble with wind knots and such. So keep it tight, spool it up, and you just keep going. All right, so here's our first setup, the fish finder rig. Same thing as on my perch setup. I got my main line here to a slider, to a bead, a swivel, and then my leader. So on the sinker, really depends on the conditions. You can go anywhere from 2 ounce all the way up to 4 or 5 ounces, you know, if it's rough. And if you really want to, you can use a teardrop sinker as well. But when I'm fishing and I have my pole and the sand spike, I like to go with the triangle sinker because that really holds the bottom the best. So I got the swivel and then the leader. Anywhere from 15 to, you could even go as high as 30-pound on the leader. The striper that we're fishing for here are really not that line shy, so you can go as high as you want. If you're having troubles, with tangles on your leader, bump up your leader, the pound test on your leader. So the heavier you are, the less tangles you'll get. But if it is, you know, a sunny, clear day, you might want to go down, bump it down a little bit, go a little bit lighter, in case those fish are being a little finicky. So that's the Carolina rig. That's the first one. Okay, so our second setup is going to be the surf leader. So again, it's pretty similar to the perch setup. The only difference is the hook. We got bigger hooks on here. So we got our main line, the 30-pound braid to a swivel, and then the leader can go anywhere from 20 to 30, or even as down as low as 15 if you want. And then we got two hooks here. So this is a good rig if you want to get your bait up off the bottom. So on the Carolina rig, you got your sinker and then your line kind of flowing off this way. I'm sitting on the bottom, but this way you got your hooks coming up off the bottom, so your bait's gonna be sitting in the middle of the water column here. So that's one good thing about this one, and then also you can, put two baits on here, just to increase your chances a little bit. So that's the surf rig. Okay, and then our last setup is going to be the plugging setup. This is my favorite way to catch striper, and I think one of the most effective ways to catch big fish around in this area. So you got your main line attached to a power swivel. I just got these Spro power swivels. Size 4, just a little guy right there, to prevent your line from twisting. And then you got about 3-4 foot leader. I like to go heavy on this one, so I think this is 30-pound leader. And then at the end is your swivel. I like to use a ball bearing swivel, which are a little more pricey, but I think it's definitely worth it when you're using plugs, because they're definitely spinning and you know, going back and forth in the water, so it's good to have a nice swivel on the end. I didn't have one here, but I just put this one in for now. And then, you know, you can put any lures on the end of this, so your SP minnows, your poppers, cast masters, if you want to throw iron, whatever you got, that'll all work for striper. So definitely one of my favorite setups for fish for striper around here, and I think pretty effective catching big fish. So that's the plugging setup, and that's the last one.
I just had a started Instagram page. I'll leave the link below. Feel free to give me a follow, keep you up to date on all the videos that are coming out. All right, that's it. Now you're good to go get some striper. I know it's about late March now, and I know they're starting to show up around here, so hopefully you can get out and get one. I've been itching to get out. I haven't got one yet this year, so I'm looking forward to getting my next one. Hopefully it's coming up in a video soon. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment below. Other than that, you know, get out there, try, and, you know, if you're plugging, just keep casting. Never give up. You never know when that 30-pounder is going to hit your lure. So, yeah, I look forward to getting back out there this year, and hopefully get one in a video coming up soon. But that's it for now. Thanks for watching. Time to seal it up.